kinda tall. I wanna stop it fall. It gets on my heart and starts to beat. Yeah, I move my feet. You're making me wait. And your love.
Hi friends, so we're here today. I'm coming at you from beautiful Piazza del Popolo here in Roma. And I'm just about to hop on the metro because I'm heading up to Termini Station, because today I'm taking you on a day trip from Rome to Florence. I'm gonna be traveling with my amazing friend Manisha, her daughter Ahana, who's just a little toddler, and Manisha's sister Shaguna. So let's go have ourselves an amazing day in beautiful Firenze. And unfortunately the girls have run into some issues getting here because today's actually the Roma marathon, so the city is kind of crazy when roads get shut down. So I'm going to show you guys what I love to do when I am heading off on a train journey from Termini, is to stop and get the traditional Italian breakfast or colazione.
Ciao, posso avere un succo arancio spremuta, un cappuccino di soia e un cornetto vegano, per favore.
Loves a force from the mountain tops. I don't know what to say. I gave my heart away. You know I got sucked in, and the truth I dare not speak.
A sea of pigeons. This is Shaguna and Manisha, and we are in Firenze, and this is your lady's first time here, right?
Yeah,
it is. Amazing. Oh, we're having so much fun.
It's been like 5 minutes and we're just amazed by everything.
Yeah, so beautiful. We're just outside the Duomo, checking it out and just enjoying a nice passeggiata in La Città.
Starts to be. Yeah, I move my feet.
So we've had an amazing walk so far and we definitely worked up an appetite. So we're at my very favorite pizza place in Florence and perhaps all of Italy. It's called Gusta Pizza, and I was originally introduced to it by my amazing friend Emily. And if you guys are interested in more content from Florence, I actually have a weekend in Florence video and I have 2 Tuscany wine tour, 1 a Vespa tour, and I think that you would love to check them out. So let's take you inside so you can check out the amazing pizzas at Gusta Pizza. Gusta pizza, but with no cheese and extra arugula.
Manisha's trying it too today.
And Shaguna, what did you get?
It has basil, tomato, mozzarella, spicy salami in it. Very exciting. It should be very spicy. I'm very excited for it.
Yeah.
We'll let you know how it turns out.
Sounds good. And cheers, girl.
Cheers. Hi.
Just in time, I found.
So, Shaguna, how was it?
Quite good. I loved it. I felt like it was just a soft. I'm still eating it.
Yeah. And the nice thing about, like, if you aren't familiar with Europe and how things work, she is cruising with her wine and the rest of her pizza, and we're totally exploring this amazing piazza, San Spirito.
Cause you're loud. Exciting. Cause you're loud.
Yeah.
Fun strolling through this market. I'm Minnie. And there's lots of antiques here, some clothing, some food. It's really interesting, and because it is a Sunday, I'm sure that this is only on Sundays, but definitely recommend coming here so you can enjoy the atmosphere of the market.
I was lost. The losing dice were tossed. My bridges all were crossed.
Alright guys, so we just stopped for La Sorbetiera, which is one of the top 10 best gelato spots here in Florence. And I got fragola, which is strawberry, and limone, and salvia, which is lemon and sage. And the lemon and sage is my favorite for sure. This is definitely amazing, very fresh tasting. I'm not sure if it's my favorite in Italy, because there's a few other ones on that list, like from San Gimignano, which are in the other Tuscany travel diaries. But so far, I mean, this is a definite crowd pleaser. I've never had lemon and sage, so I always like to try these kind of artisanal type of gelato or gelati. So yeah, be sure that you check this place out next time you're in Florence, or if you're from Florence and have visited before, do you have any other recommendations for me to hit next time?
All love's the source to which I plot my course. I don't know where to look. I'll rest upon.
Hey guys, so we're nearing sunset now. We're just in the piazza. Oops. We got some friends happening. And we had an amazing day. We just walked all over Florence. It's truly a very walkable city and so charming. You just always have an amazing, magical time here. And we also did a little bit of shopping. But I think I'm gonna save it for a favorites video. So be sure that you hit that subscribe button down below. And of course, give this a thumbs up if you enjoyed exploring Florence with me today. I definitely recommend visiting Florence for more than just one day if it's your first time here, because there's a lot to experience, especially if you wanna go into the museums and see Michelangelo's David or something like that. You never wanna feel rushed, I guess, I suppose I'll say. But for now, we're gonna watch some live music, and then I will head to the train station and then back to Roma. So yeah, like I said, it's about an hour until sunset, so I'm just gonna soak it all in while I can. Ponte Vecchio behind me, and the sun is setting, and I'm just going to go back to the girls' Airbnb, grab my bag, and then I'm going to head to the train station. So I've gotten a round trip, like Rome to Florence via train, for as cheap as I think 40 euros. But today, just because this was kind of a last minute, spontaneous trip, I think I paid just over 40 euros each way, which is a little bit more on the pricier side, but I'm definitely gonna leave the link to the app Go Euro below. Not sponsored whatsoever, but I find that that's where I can find some amazing deals sometimes, so I hope that helps you guys out. And we did have like a little aperitivo in the piazza, and then I got myself a wrap from Shake Cafe. I don't think I've ever not gone to Shake Cafe when I've been to Florence, just because it's really easy to get like something healthy or like a vegan fix. Like I had a vegan wrap and it was delicious. I've gotten smoothies there, fresh juices, and it's always amazing. And yeah, so I'm gonna go grab my bag and then we're off back to Roma.
Starts to be. Yeah, I'm